Alexa, play Future Radio on Pandora.
Yeah. Yeah. Go. That's a vibe. She wanna vibe. That's a vibe. Yeah. That's a vibe. It's a vibe. That's a vibe. Yeah. Yeah. That's a vibe. Oh, it's a vibe. And that's a vibe. Yeah. That's a vibe. She wanna vibe. That's a vibe. Yeah. Yeah.
Wouldn't put you guys out. I like it.
Gotta pay to be there. Gotta. It's blue collar. We're gritty this go around. USA.
Connor Kelly, did he play well?
Yeah, he did. Yeah, he played really good. He's stud.
He's tough, isn't he?
Yeah, he's good. All right. Well, I'm gonna get in there. Get sweat going. We need an Alexa for in here. Don't you think, Alex? Imagine if you could just walk in here, Alexa. Oh, Leo. Ready, bud? Ready? Oh, watch out! It's in that. It's in that. Get in there. Beast. Oh, watch out, Lee. See, we're taking checks. He's an eighth grader though, this kid. I'm shooting as hard as I can on him. Leo! here you go. Come on, bud. All right, you guys can get back to your lesson now. I was born in Southern California. I moved to Atlanta when I was 4, and I'd already had a lacrosse stick at that point in my life. My dad played in college at University of Maryland, so it was the sport I was introduced to at a really young age. I remember the league just had 4 teams. It was called Atlanta Youth Lacrosse. It was here in Buckhead. You know, being from Atlanta is something that I've talked about from college into the pros, like motivating me. And you know, I always kind of had a chip on my shoulder and felt like I was doubted because I was the only person from here. So to have a chance to come back and play at home and continue to try to pump up this lacrosse community, and then also a lot of the coaches and friends that helped me to get to where I got to in lacrosse are still back here coaching high school, running clubs, doing those different things. So to come back and be able to get involved with them and help grow lacrosse in this community, and now with the Swarm and the Blaze, it's been awesome. This is my girlfriend Alexa. She's just kidding, but I love this thing right here. The boys come over and they make fun of it, but I think it's awesome. I wake up in the morning and tell her to play Future Radio. She's not listening right now. I've had Leo for almost 2 years now. Got him when he was a month old. I think he's a little bit of a mutt, but mainly Aussie Shepherd and Lab. Paul? Other Paul? Down? Good boy. Good boy. This is my Loyola helmet. I think that was from 2012, the year that we won it. And I got the ring over here too, which is always maybe a little nicer for the camera. Gotta keep those things close. The boys, that was the Reed Acton. Shout out Reed Acton. Davis Butts, he just got married. Obviously Hawk still playing, and Tyler Foley. Those were some of the, we called ourselves the first line. Some of the good boys in college. Just moved up to the S, so got the old R opposite up there. Keeps the balance with the Loyola and the Blaze helmet. Got my Utah visor. Also give a shout out to those guys right here. So this is Jim Fenzel's artist who does a lot of lacrosse and mascot drawings and paintings, and I got him to, this is my dad, who played at Maryland in the 70s and has been a big part of my lacrosse career and life, obviously, and he put us both playing against Hopkins, obviously a common rival of us, and he said he's throwing an outlet pass up the field to me, and it's pretty cool because these are both real pictures, and he nailed it, like the details, that's kind of some of the differences, like my dad always held his stick at the bottom where I'm choked up, and just little things like that. He even got the knee band, so he did an awesome job. That's definitely something that's cool and special to me, and sent over a couple of them, so my dad's got one hanging up at his house as well. See, what happens is these practices are scheduled for 8:30, but almost always somebody like gets in late or flights are delayed and like all get there at 8 and we won't start practice till like 10 o'clock. That's like pretty much become the norm. And that's another one of the struggles of the league is flights get canceled and stuff and guys do crazy things to get to games. You know, you have really different rosters every week. I mean, we're playing the Bayhawks this week and they're a perfect example. You know, when we played them up in Baltimore, you know, both teams looked completely different. So, you know, you really got to try to find that on and off the field chemistry really fast, and it helps when you are able to keep a core of guys together on the same team for a couple years. And I think we've seen a lot of growth within our own locker room now, having year two with Adam and with Kevin and with Justin Pennington and with some of the guys that we have leading this team. And I feel like we're further along now than we were at this point last year.
Kidding back.
How you saving that?
When you can get your stick like that motion, it's...
No. Oh, there you go, Hoss! Hoss with the hit!
I played short stick O-Midi a lot in high school, and when I would play long pull, I would run the ball up the field a lot, and I was always involved in offense. It took me a few years at Loyola to kind of catch up and get the skill set where I could do that in college, but then I was lucky enough to play on a college team that let me stay on and run sets. So it's not something that's new to me. I think it's just different for people to see. And this year, you know, we were having trouble giving up transition the other way, and so Coach Huntley was like, I came up with the idea to keep me on the field to take away transition and make teams play us in 6-on-6, but you know, I'm able to step down and take shots or get involved in the offense to make them respect me and guard me. So for me, it's like a dream come true. I've always definitely hated when I get labeled defense. You know, I feel like the position's called long stick middy, so we're midfielders.
Hot mic, watch him say. What's up, Kev? How you doing, buddy? What up, Git?
I'm working for a leadership development company called Empowerhouse Group, and that's something that, you know, leadership development, I've always been interested in it. I've always been the type of guy that tries to strive to be a captain and do those sorts of things. And so I wanted to kind of pursue that as I started coaching more and more. What I realized was, as much as I do love lacrosse and being around it, you know, I really like trying to develop the people and figure out the work ethic and the different things to help these kids be successful, as much as I liked coaching the skills of the game. So this has kind of given me a chance to bridge that gap and to try to, you know, make an impact on a lot of different people. And I'm doing different programs with high school kids in the area and trying to help them not only on the field figure out what it takes and what to do, but off the field as well.
Your echo lost its connection.
Jeez.
Sorry, I'm having trouble understanding right now. Please try a little later.
You can't goad her when it's already lit. You can't goad her again. That's your impatience. This is what leads to her struggles. No, she's off now. The Wi-Fi.
Sorry, I'm having trouble understanding right now.
All right, let's go.
Please try a little later.
It's okay, baby.
Next time.
Play Future Radio on Pandora.
Getting your Future Radio station from Pandora.
Hold on.
She speaks to me. See, she speaks to me.
Fuck being on some chair shit. We go 0 to 100 real quick. Baby, on every.